Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's session, we will see how we can install SAP GUI 770. I have already made so many videos on my YouTube channel like how to install SAP 740, how to install SAP GUI 760 version and how to install SAP GUI 8.00 version. But in today's session, we will see how to install SAP GUI 770, as so many of friends of mine were requesting me to make a video on how to install SAP GUI 770, as most of the employees or most of the students are more familiar with 770. So I thought to make a video like how you can install and how you can download SAP GUI 770. So we will see how we can install, how we can extract that file and how we can download, and then how we can add the servers on that SAP GUI. So whenever someone just want to practice on SAP, they just need to install SAP GUI, as SAP GUI is a front end installer. So they just need to install that SAP GUI. And on that SAP GUI, they just need to add the server credentials, and then they can just take the server credentials on rent from any server provider, and after that they can log in and they can practice, right? Directly they can't practice on SAP, right? Like another way is there, like directly with the help of remote access you can use that SAP, but I don't suggest that option because that's not more user friendly. If you use SAP with the help of SAP GUI, it's more user friendly because connection doesn't break so often. So these are some merits to use SAP with on SAP GUI, right? So that's all, and that's a one time activity. Like you just need to install one time, and then every time you just come and you can give your user ID and password, and you can simply login in very simple steps, right? So in today's session we will see, and I already made a videos on different versions like 740, 760, 8.00. I have already made a video how you can find that on my YouTube channel. You just need to go to SAP installation playlist. Here you can see SAP installation playlist is there. You just need to go to that playlist. And I have made all the videos. This one is for 740, this one is for 760, this one is for 8.00, right? So you can simply follow these videos and you can simply install SAP GUI with the help of these videos. But in today's session, we will see how to install SAP GUI 770. And for these videos, I will also mention a link in the description box of this video. So now let's get started. How we can install 770, right? And before starting, I will just request you, if you came to our YouTube channel for first time, just make sure to subscribe our YouTube channel, as we used to make very useful videos for SAP and different domain. We are making videos for all functional and technical modules, very informative videos we used to make. So definitely that will help you in your learning journey. Definitely this channel will help you. So now let's get started without any delay. Let's get started. So what you need to do in that video, you will see the first comment or first pinned comment. There you can see download link for SAP GUI. So just go to comment section of this video, that same video, and you will see SAP download link. So there is a drive link. So you just need to click on that link and you can easily download that. You just need to click on download and you can simply download that. Student used to ask, or SAP professionals used to ask, sir, what's the prerequisites to download that SAP 770? So like minimum configurations is also fine, because it's just I guess a 500 or 600 MB file, so you can easily download that. And in some cases, if you have pre-installed antivirus, then you will not able to download that setup. So make sure, if you are not able to download, make sure to either stop or uninstall that antivirus, right? So just go to that comment section, and in description box also it's available. So just go and click on that link and you can simply download that. I have already downloaded that. Okay, to save some time, I have already downloaded that setup. Okay, so what you need to do, once it's downloaded, just double click on that setup. Right, then this will open. So just double click on this. Just double click on press 1. Just double click on GUI. Double click on Windows. Double click on Win32. And you can see in drop down, you can see setup all option is there. So just double click on setup all. And we are going to extract that. So three options are available: extract all, run, and cancel. So just click on extract all. And from here, you can give the location, like on which folder you just want to extract that. So what I will do, I just made a folder on desktop with name SAP GUI. You can also do the same. Just make a folder SAP GUI on desktop. And I'm selecting that same folder and I'm extracting that. Just click on extract. So it will start extracting. It will take some time, 1 to 2 minutes. Okay, so just wait for that. And some students or some working professionals, mostly student have a doubt, sir, without server can I practice SAP? No, you can't practice. Server you have to take on rent, but that GUI is also mandatory. Without the GUI also you can't use server. So both are important. That GUI is like available free of cost from SAP website also. You can simply download if you have S user ID and if you have like access to download SAP product, like if your company have given that access, then you can download that. Otherwise you can simply download from my video. In very simple step, you can download and install and to like any of the SAP GUI version 7607408007700, and I will also make a video on 750, right? On that same playlist, you can check out that all videos are available. So that just came again. I will just double click again on that. Again, I will click on press 1, click on GUI, double click on Windows, double click on Win32, and I will just click on that setup all. And like one pop-up message just came that you can't see in that recording. That is, do you want to allow this app to make a changes to your device? So I will give the permission to my system to download that app, right? So I'm going to give the permission. I'm going to select yes. So like don't worry about that thing. You can simply give the permission to your system. It's totally safe. So I'm just giving yes. Without giving permission, you can't install that. Now it's started installing. So it will take some more time. Right, so it's installed. Just click on next. Right, so that error is coming in that. I will select all. I will select all. Now you just need to select all. You will see two options here, select all and deselect all, and you just need to click on next. Next. Next, next, and it will start installing. Right? So it's simply started installing. It will take some more 1 or 2 minutes. And if you find this video useful, please share this video to your SAP circle so that they can easily install that SAP GUI 770. And please make sure to like this video, because if you're going to like that video, definitely it give a motivation to us to keep making and uploading these type of videos, right? So please make sure to like this video. In this video, we will see like from end to end how we can install, how we can add server credentials, and from where we can take server on rent, and how we can practice. That all we will see. So we are going to like it's saying to reboot that. So let me close, let me try without doing that. I will just minimize all these folders. Right? So you can see that SAP logon will come. This SAP logon icon will come on your desktop. Okay? And this is like SAP Business Client 770. So never like delete all these folders, otherwise you will not able to use SAP properly. So what you can do, like in that folder, I will just cut and paste that. Okay. So sometimes what happen, like so many users are complaining me, like, sir, I'm not able to use SAP. So this is because by mistake you just deleted that business client or some of the file from that. So that happened because of that specific reason. So you will see that SAP logon. I will just double click on that. Okay, you can see 770 final release. This is the latest release for 770. And from here also you can see it's 770 final release. And this is file version. This is a build patch level. Everything you can see from here, right? And in my case, I'm seeing so many servers because I have my own database and I'm server provider also. So this is the reason I'm like you are able to see these many of servers. And I'm also working on some of the clients. So that's the reason you are seeing these many of servers. But in your case, that will be blank. Okay, that will be blank. Like nothing will be here. So you just need to take server on rent. You can take server from like anywhere in the market. We are also providing server, like all modules we are providing server. So you can also take from us, and if you want to take from somewhere else, if you know some like server provider whom you can trust, because like so many spammers also there in the market. So just check out, like make sure like they are genuine server provider. They have something to show you, okay? And you can take the server from rent. And once they will send you the details, how you are going to add these details and how you are going to use that server. Let's suppose you have taken from me or from someone else. What you need to do, for first time, you just need to add these server credentials. So how you are going to do? Just click on that page icon. Here you can see a page icon, new. That's for new. Just click on that new and just click on connections. You will see this screen will come. Just click on next and all these details your server provider will provide to you. So you just need to give all these details here. So I'm giving the details like I'm giving S/4HANA, right? Development, or let me give test server, practice test server, right? And application server, all these details server provider will give. So I'm giving just my details here. Instance number you just need to mention here. So let me give here instance number also. System ID you just need to mention here. So I'm giving system ID. So system ID in my case is like A4H. SAP router string is not required. SAP router string is required only for Mac. For Windows, you can just leave that blank. It's not required. So just click on next. Just click on finish. And you can see like whatever descriptions I have given, that same server name is coming here. S/4HANA test server. So that's server name, whatever you have added, that will come. And all these details, you have to take on rent from server provider. Okay, so you just need to double click on that and you will able to see that login screen. That's a login screen. Okay, and here you just need to give your user ID and password. So I'm just giving my user ID and password. That will not work for you because server you have to take on rent. So simply that will not work in your case. Okay, don't try to do that because that will not work, right? And I'm giving my password here. Just hit enter and I'm able to log in. So this is SAP Easy Access screen, the first screen that we can see. and like we can see SPRO, all nodes we can see. You can practice any of the module here. So you can whatever like material management, sales and distribution, FICO, financial and controlling, everything you can practice from here, right? And you can configure whatever you want to configure, you can configure from here. So we have a server for like technical module, functional module like MM, SD, FICO, PP, QM, HCM, payroll, everything we have. For ABAP also we have server. For almost all modules we have a server. And if you want to take server on rent from us, you can simply connect me on the WhatsApp number that I'm going to mention in the description box of this video. You can simply WhatsApp me and you can connect to our team and you can ask the price. And if you like all these things, you can take server on rent, right? So this is how you can download SAP 7.7.0 and how you can extract that and how you can install that and how you can add the server credentials on that SAP GUI, graphical user interface. So that's how you are going to do that. Now all set. Now you can do a practice daily, right? This is how what you need to do, and that's a one-time activity. It's not like every time you need to do. Every time what you need to do, you just need to come to that SAP logon, just double click on that, and you just need to double click on your server, whatever server you have taken on rent. Let's suppose you have taken any of these server, you just need to double click on that. You just need to give your user ID and password here, right? User ID and password, hit enter, right? Hit enter. This is how you need to do every day. Every time you need not to install, that's just a one-time activity, right? So one time we have done, it's done, right? So if you find this video helpful, please like this video, comment your thoughts. If you are able to download that SAP with the help of this video, please comment in comment section like, sir, I have able to download that video with the help of that installation guide. Okay, I try to make it very simple so that you can easily download that. And I have tried to make videos very simple, like how to book a certification and how to clear that in single attempt. I have made several videos on that also. That also you can check on my playlist, right? So on several topics, we used to make videos. I used to make videos. Best of the best trainer used to make a videos, right? So you can check out all these videos. That will be very helpful for you, for your career, right? SAP Global Certification videos are here, like how SAP used to conduct exam. Each and every videos are available. How to crack the exam in single attempt, how to register for exam. Each and every videos I just made in very detailed manner. So you can just go through that videos, okay? So hopefully you are able to install and download that SAP GUI 7.7.0. If you are, please make sure to share in your SAP circle, as sharing is a caring. So thank you guys. Thanks a lot. May God bless you all.